Dear friends, welcome to the channel The Eastern Front. If you pay attention to the German tanks and the semi-truck tractors of the period of the Second World War, you will notice that the support rollers were staggered on them. This solution was proposed by the German engineer and inventor Heinrich Kanevsky. If you look at our armored vehicles of that period, you will see that the Soviet engineers decided not to complicate the design, and the support rollers were arranged in one row. This applies to light, medium and heavy tanks of the Red Army. As you know, the Germans do nothing for nothing, and this case is no exception. But this arrangement of ice rings had both pros and cons, which I will tell you about now. Firstly, the staggered arrangement of the rollers significantly increased the smoothness of the tank, which was important both for the comfort of the crew and for accurate shooting in motion. Secondly, when the rollers were arranged in several rows, it was necessary to use wider tracks, as a result of which the area of adhesion to the ground was larger, and this improved cross-country ability in mud and snow. Thirdly, by increasing the number of support rollers, the weight of each roller was reduced. The durability of rubber bands on the rollers themselves increased, since the mass of the tank was distributed to a larger number of them. But such an engineered solution also had significant drawbacks. Firstly, since the distance between the skating rings was small, dirt and snow accumulated there very quickly, which had to be constantly cleaned. And if this was not done, then, when stopping on a frosty night, all this would freeze and the tank simply wouldn't be able to move. Secondly, any equipment, even German, requires maintenance and repair. And when it was necessary to change the bearing of the inner roller, it was necessary to remove all the rows of rollers in front of it. And for German tankers, it was a living hell. Thirdly, due to the large number of ice rings, their production turned out to be much more expensive. As a result of all this in the post-war period, and even in our time, such an arrangement of ice rings is no longer used. Dear friends, that's all for today. By the way, I have an interesting video about how Soviet and German tankers heated themselves in tanks in winter. And it was Tim and the Eastern Front channel. As usual, I wish you peace and health. See you.